A very good morning to class 11th commerce. First of all, I welcome you in the new session, new class and new subject. My dear, as you have chosen this subject commerce, I congratulate everyone for choosing this subject. As you know, there are three subjects in our school. That is Maths, Bio and Commerce. Each subject has its self-importance, its own importance. But I would like to focus your mind towards the Commerce, that subject you have taken. My dear, Commerce subjects, Commerce field in this age is very important. It is called job-oriented field, job-oriented subject. So, finally, I would like to congratulate, and I am just starting the subject, my dear. As you have taken the subject commerce, so I will focus the subject. The simple meaning of commerce, that is business of purchasing, that is known as buying, and selling, means commerce is fully related to a business and business is related to purchasing and selling. Listen, my dear, this is a new subject, new field, so each and every term is new for you. So you just try to understand and try to learn each new term of this subject. As I told, business, purchasing, selling, buying. So first of all, you should know the meaning of business. The word business is very popular word, you know. But the meaning of business in the commerce, that is entirely different. Any task, any work, for the earning profit, that may be business for he or her, for him or her. But the business meaning in the commerce is entirely different. That is defined as any legal work or any legal task, any legal effort for earning profit is known as business. So you should know, when you are learning about the business, you should keep in mind that any legal work, the work should be legal, the task should be legal, and the motive of the work or the task, that should be to earn profit. Everyone, every businessman, businessman wants to earn profit, but unfortunately, due to mishappening, there may be another word, that is loss. So my dear, this is the first term I taught you, the business. You just note down in your copy that business is any legal work, any legal effort, any legal task for earning profit. You may take the help of the book. The second thing, these are the two verbs, purchasing and selling. They are very common. Purchasing, that can be said, buying. They are very popular words. And after that, I have just shown the arrow. The purchasing and selling, that is related to goods or services. Goods. Now the word goods is also a very new term in the commerce field. Services, goods and services, when there may be purchasing and selling of goods as well as services. It is very difficult to digest this thing, but goods are services, they are purchased and they are sold. So my dear, these are the very simple meaning of the commerce, that the commerce is related to business and business business of purchasing and selling, and I have told about the business and the goods and service. I will explain these two terms, goods and services, later on. Now, as you have taken the subject commerce, so I would like to explain you about the subjects of the commerce. Subjects of the commerce. There are three main subjects in the commerce. In class 11, there are three subjects. First is accountancy, which I am just going to teach you. The second subject is known as business studies. And the third subject is economics. So this year, my dear, you have to study over these three subjects, accountancy, business studies, economics. And they are connected with the commerce. In the field of commerce, in class 11, you will learn about accountancy, business studies, economics. These are the three subjects. Now, in a very short, I will just explain what is accountancy. So, accountancy that is simply recording of the transactions. And the word transactions, again, it is a new word. My dear, as I just tell you the new word, new term, you just keep it in your mind and try to make the notes for that. Accountancy is recording of business transaction, and transactions, they are known as activities. Means business activities. Here I have just explained the term transaction. Business activities with monetary term, that is known as transaction. Yes, my dear, you learned the business word, you learned the subject name, and transaction is business activities with monetary value, monetary term, means the activity of the business which can be defined with money or monetary value, that only is known as transaction. I will just explain you the vast meaning of transaction later on. You just patiently listen my speech regarding the commerce and the subjects. So my dear, the simple, very simple, actual the accountancy is not only recording of the business activities, there is more things. Business studies, the second subject, in very short, I will explain this. I will teach this subject also. I will teach accountancy and business studies both. Business studies, about the business, controlling the business, how the business is controlled, and management of the business, how the business is managed. Planning and different types of the business. In this field, we will learn about these topics, and there are so many other topics. And the third subject, economics, that will be taught by the other teacher. I will take these two subjects, the economics that will be taught by Madam Adhikari. And economics that is related to market. My dear, commerce is directly related to business, and in the business, market is required, price is there, demand is there, supply is there. So, and more things are there that will be taught in this subject. So, this is the simple and very short introduction of the subjects in commerce. Now, we are just going to the main topic, that is accountancy. Accountancy is your first subject and the very important and the practical subject of the commerce. And accountancy is said bookkeeping and accountancy. Bookkeeping and accountancy. You just listen, here. Bookkeeping and accountancy, the full name of the subject is known as bookkeeping and accountancy. Clear? You just don't see this word. This is the subject, bookkeeping and accountancy. And I will explain the simple meaning of the first part of the subject, that is bookkeeping. Bookkeeping is recording of business transaction, as I taught here. That the accountancy that is related to recording of the business transaction, but that was incomplete. Bookkeeping is recording of the business transaction, and I told you transactions, they are business activities with monetary term. So my dear, recording of the business transaction and transactions are again defined here. Transaction, as I told you, business activities with monetary term, that is known as transaction. And the accountancy, the second part of the subject, the whole subject is known as bookkeeping and accountancy, right? And accountancy is related to recording, classification, summarizing, analyzing, that is the making result, that is profit or loss. When we are doing a business, so our motive is to earn profit, and profit will be calculated through accountancy. First part is only recording, and second part is recording as well as classification, summarizing, analyzing, processing. So this is the meaning of the, you can say, what do you mean by the bookkeeping? So simply you can say, bookkeeping is the recording of the business transactions in very sharp. You will get the detailed definition of the bookkeeping in your book. Listen, my dear, so many times I am telling you about transaction. Transactions, see, I have written here one transaction, purchase a big machine, and just in front of that, I have just changed, added some monetary value. Purchase a big machine for rupees 10,000. So my dear, this one is not a transaction. Purchase a machine is not a transaction because there is no monetary value. But purchase a big machine for rupees 10,000 because of this monetary value, this is a transaction. Sold goods to Ramesh. This is also a business activity. Sold goods to Ramesh. As I told you, purchase and sell. These are the two activities. Sold goods to Ramesh is not a business transaction. This is not a business transaction. But when it is written in this form, sold goods to Ramesh worth rupees 5,000, because of this monetary value, this is a transaction. Means transaction is a business activity along with the monetary character. When monetary character is given, then only it becomes transaction. Now my dear, as I told you, the goods is a very popular word in the business. Goods, as here I have written, anything or article which is purchased or produced, that is produced in the business, purchased or produced in the business to sell it again. If I am manufacturer of cement, or I am manufacturer of iron, aluminium, whatever. So it is my business that I produce cement, and after producing, I sell it again in the market, and through that activity, I earn profit. profit is the main motive. So anything or article which is purchased or produced in the business to sell it again to earn profit, to earn profit, that is known as transaction, that is known as goods. So goods, as I told you, that I am producing cement and selling it into the in the market. But as you live in Korba, cement or iron is not produced in the Korba area, but cement is available. Some people, they are busy in purchasing cement from the producer, from the factory, and they are selling in the market, in the Korba market. One activity, one business that the production is going on, productive business. And the second thing, one person is busy in purchasing cement from the producer and selling in the market. Both are having a business. So cement for both the traders, if I am a fruit vendor, very simple, common, if I am selling fruit, so fruit is my goods, as I am just mentioning this word goods. So if I am fruit vendor, fruit is my goods. If I am cloth vendor, cloth seller, if I am cloth seller, so cloth is my goods. If I am having a stationery mart, so what items are kept in the stationery marts? Books, pen, pencil, rubber, etc. All these are goods. So it is very simple, my dear. The goods is that commodity which is purchased. I am having a cloth store. I am not producing the cloths. Cloth is produced in the different area, Mumbai or the Hyderabad, etc. But cloth is available in the Korba market. I purchase cloth from manufacturer and I sell it. So if I am seller of cloth in the Dindayal market, Korba, so cloth is my goods. I purchase from the manufacturer and I sell it in the market, in the to the consumers, and I earn profit. So goods, that is very simple term and very important. My dear, you make a notes for the word goods to take help from your book also. Once again, now I am just, once again I would like to explain bookkeeping. As I have told here, bookkeeping, that the bookkeeping is recording of the business transaction. Here I have written, see, bookkeeping, a systematic method. I told you about the transactions. I have just explained two transactions. And just I told, this is not transaction, this is transaction because of the monetary corrector. A systematic method of recording the business transaction in the books. Bookkeeping, actual the subject is accountancy, as I mentioned, but the whole subject is known as accountancy. Accountancy also include bookkeeping. So a systematic method of recording the business transactions in the books are called big registers, are called books in the business. So the systematic method is required to record the business transactions. Clear, my dear? The method or system. A systematic method or a system is required to record the business transactions. Method or system. So one method that is followed in the commerce field for the business, that is known as double entry system. Means first we have to recognize the transactions. Transactions are the business activities with monetary character, and after that though the transactions of the business they are recorded, and recording is known as bookkeeping. That the systematic method of recording the business transaction in the books, that is known as bookkeeping. So the method or the system which is followed to record the business transaction, that is known as double entry system. My dear student, this is the first period, and from here only you focus your mind or you concentrate your minds towards the subject. Double entry system, this is required to record the business transaction. As the word double is very common, double means two. Each transaction I have explained, whenever or when you learn the term, if you know about the transaction, then only you can understand the double entry. Each transaction has two sides are two effects. One transaction, as it is explained here, purchase a big machine for ₹10,000, it is a transaction. This transaction has two effects or two sides. Each transaction has two folds. You can say two sides, two effects, two folds, whatever. Everything is two because we are talking about the double entry system. In each transaction, two accounts are affected. Of the word, now the new word that comes, that is accounts. Accounts is a very, as the subject is accountancy, we should know the meaning of the word accounts. Accounts, the short form of account, that is A/C. This is the short form for account. Records of the business transaction. Records of the business transaction. As I told you, in the double entry system, each transaction has two sides, or in each transaction, two accounts are affected. Clear? So, accounts are the record of the business transaction. Listen, means if there is a transaction, it has two sides or two folds, two accounts are affected. One account and two accounts. Transaction, if you know the meaning of transaction, there are two accounts affected. Simply, I am explaining one transaction. Mohan started his business. Mohan is a businessman. Clear? Mohan started his business with cash rupees 5 lakhs. This is a transaction because this is a business activity and this is the monetary character. In this transaction, In the business, there will be two records. One, that the cash account will be affected. This will be recorded, and the second is Mohan's account, or another word, capital, that is another new term, capital. Capital is very common in the economic subject, and already I think in class 9th or 10th you have learned the economics. You should know the meaning of capital, but I will explain the detailed meaning of capital in the commerce field. So when Mohan started his business with cash rupees 5 lakh, Mohan is businessman, and that is 5 lakh is his capital. That amount is invested in the business. My dear, I am just concluding the subject here. I would like to tell you, this big circle is business. This big circle is business, and I have made a small circle, that is businessman. It is for Mohan. Right? It is Mohan. Business and businessman. Keep in your mind very perfectly that all the recording, systematic method of the recording the business transaction. Recording of the business transaction, that is done for business, not for businessman, not for Mohan. This is the concept of the accountancy that all the business transactions, they are recorded for the business, not for the businessman. So when there is the requirement of recording of this transaction, so these two accounts will be recorded. First, cash account. First, cash account, and the second, capital account. Capital account. These two accounts will be maintained in the big circle, that is business. Means this is the business activities and this is the recording. My dear student, this is the enough in this period that we could learn about the commerce, subject of the commerce, three subjects, accountancy, business studies, economics. We could learn about the accountancy, we could learn about the transactions, we could learn about the goods, and the finally I told you the bookkeeping, because first we have to learn the bookkeeping, and in the bookkeeping there is only recording. After recording there are so many processes, and I told you that the for recording one system is required, that is double entry system. And double entry system, here I have just divided a transaction into two parts, two accounts, and that will be recorded here. So my dear, you take the help of the book, and then we will discuss in the next period. Have a thank you very much. Have a nice day. Thank you very much.